Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk a little bit more about Invisalign conventional attachments, Invisalign optimized attachments, and I'm going to break it down for you a little bit. I do have kind of a nifty handout that I got from Invisalign somehow. One of my awesome clients gave it to me that came from the UK Invisalign. I can't post it because it's not my content, so if you want it, I'll give it to you. I can't sell it. It's not my content, so you can just email me, info@straightsmilesolutions.com, or contact me through my website, straightsmilesolutions.com, and I'll be super glad to give you a copy of that. I'm going to break it down based on what I can share, which is just talking a little bit about optimized attachments, which are on the left, and conventional attachments that are on the right. Personally, to me, I don't get too obsessed about these attachments, the shapes, what goes on. I'll kind of go over like when you want an attachment, when you don't want an attachment. And no, I did my own drawings because I can't use their photos from the Clin Checks because that would be violating their content, right? So they like to come after me when I do stuff like that. You would think they wouldn't because I'm helping them out, but they do. So I have to be really careful what I post from Invisalign. But in any case, so your conventional attachments are the original attachments. I believe most of the conventional attachments no longer are patent protected. That means, I mean, don't take me exactly. They've got thousands of patents and, IP technology, and that's part of their R&D, is part of the reason why they're such a successful company. Hopefully their stock will go up this year. But in any case, I mean, that's why they stay. For those of you who are doing Spark and Sure Smile and all these other ones, I'm sorry, but it is, you guys are miles behind. You'll never ever be the same thing as Align technology. They're just 20 years ahead of you in terms of aligners. Whenever I have a hard case, it's always going to be Invisalign. I'm sorry, you guys can say whatever you want, but it's just that much better. For simple cases, it usually doesn't matter, to be really honest. I use a white label company called Global. If you ever want to use them, if you're in the US, it's only $90 per setup, $20 per aligner. Works out just as well as if you're thinking about using Go or Light or Moderate, it's the exact same thing, literally. The plastic is slightly different. It works just as well, though. They use a really good plastic. So this doesn't come in the fancy containers. But in any case, but for harder cases, we do use Invisalign. So, and by harder cases, I mean cases with more than 6 millimeters crowding or spacing, cases where we need major distalization, cases where we need to really open the vertical. There might be some transverse issues, anterior crossbite issues, class 2, class 3, things like that. Those are going to go to Invisalign always for me. And you guys, I've never worked for Align Technology. I've never gotten any kickback for them. I've never lectured for them. The only thing I've gotten them from them is pretty much grief in the last 20 years. So they don't treat me well at all, to be honest, given that I probably throw them a ton of business because I do like their product. But, you know, it's a love-hate relationship. So I'm going to keep making my content to help my doctors out because that's what they're asking for. And Align Technology is probably going to profit from what I do and never say thank you. But anyways, all right, so we got conventional attachments on the right. Anyone can use these attachments. So that's why you see these type of attachments in a lot of white label companies and other types of companies. The optimized attachments, I believe most of them are still IP. They're protected. To me, I do just fine with these attachments. So, I mean, I don't get too excited about optimized attachments, nor do I memorize what they all do, nor do I even care. For me, it's like, do I want an attachment or do I not? Well, how do I know? I usually let the software do it. So the worst thing you can do, you're never gonna be as smart as the software, I'm sorry. And there's just no reason for you to waste your time trying to memorize. This type of attachment has 10 degrees of root tip, so I should use this, optimize this. What? That's a complete waste of dentistry. That is not what dentistry is about. There's a reason why there's AI in their software. Let their software decide if you need an attachment or not. Now, the tricky part can be is when you try to control the process, like patient doesn't want attachments on upper 3-3. Well, now you may not get a predictable outcome because you just cut them off at the knees. If the tooth needs an attachment, it needs an attachment and you got to put it on or you're not going to get what you want. So let the software, don't tell them where you don't want attachments. See if it needs one and then you can decide whether, you know, it's going to be okay to not put one on there. And that goes with crowns, veneers, bridges. I mean, obviously bridges is not going to get attachment. Implants is not going to get attachment. But in terms of crowns, I like to see where it's recommended and then I'll decide, okay, am I going to try to prep this crown with the hydrofluoric acid? I'm going to rough it up. I might have to cut a hole in the crown, or am I not? You know, because a lot of you are trying to dictate and control the narrative. You're removing attachments, or you're replacing them, and you're not getting what you want because you're not letting the software do what it says. So, okay, so that's how simple my video is. Let the software do its thing. So obviously, any type of movement that's extrusive in nature is gonna need an attachment. Any type of movement that involves major root upbringing is gonna need an attachment. Major rotation, gonna need an attachment. Major translation, gonna need an attachment. If it's just a minor movement with intrusion, probably doesn't need an attachment. And a lot of this also is gonna depend on the height of contour and the morphology of the tooth, which is, again, something you'll never ever be able to learn or memorize, and you shouldn't be. What a waste of brain space. You're not a computer. Let the computer do it. We have computers for a reason. So that is pretty much it. I mean, you just have to kind of think about it, right? So like this, obviously I can't show it in a 3D space, but these optimized extrusion attachments, they're gonna have like a flatter plane at the top, you know, to pull the tooth down so there's more surface area, right? And these root control ones, they've got one force coming from one side, one force, it's a counter moment. We use these in ortho all the time. So this is like basic ortho braces 101. You will never fully understand Invisalign attachments unless you understand braces, and that's just a fact check. You're doing things backwards. You have to do basic ortho before you can understand Invisalign. You can do your best, but you'll never understand it to the level that an orthodontist will understand it, which is probably why your ClinChecks are not working out. So if your ClinChecks are not tracking, if you're doing multiple refinements, you're doing something wrong. You're probably trying to control things too much, or you're using a more limited product, or you're letting them shortchange you on the amount of aligners. Remember, most orthodontist cases are 50 to 100 aligners, whereas the default ClinChecks are always like 30 or less. My cases are not that short. So why? Because it's not going to work out. It's highly unlikely it's going to work out. Remember, they're a public company, so their goal is to control and cut costs. They're going to shortchange you on the amount of trays. It might work, it probably won't. It's cheaper for them to have you do multiple refinements, now, especially now that you're paying for shipping, than to give you a lot of aligners up front. Why? Because a lot of times patients are satisfied enough and they don't want to do the refinement. So it's cheaper for the company. Hey, they're a business, I get it. It's not that they're a bad company. If it was a private company and I was really into outcomes, you know, then maybe I would do things differently, but they're a public company, so that's how they have to run their business. You guys as a dentist need to be smarter, knowing that what they give you is gonna be crap initially, but you can make it treasure. You can take a turd and make it treasure, okay? All my ClinChecks are treasures. I turn them from turds to treasure. This is a terrible analogy at 5 a.m, but that is the title of this video, Turd to Treasure. Matter of fact, I'm gonna put it in the video. Thank you so much. Oh gosh, I'm too much coffee this morning. But anyways, hopefully this helps you get all excited. Don't get too into the attachments. If it needs one, put one on. Laterals, I always put big, chunky, full-size, rectangular attachments on my upper laterals if they are tipped or rotated at all, or if they need extrusions, they're gonna get the biggest possible attachments. If things are high and dry, they're gonna get big attachments. So I'm gonna do the ClinCheck first before I start pulling attachments off, you know, crowns and stuff like that. I'm gonna get to the final outcome. I'm gonna double or triple the amount of aligners. Then I'm gonna look for blue or black dots. Obviously anything with a blue and black dot is gonna get a big, gigantic attachment, even if they didn't say one, unless it's intrusion, and then I don't usually care. What else? I'm gonna scan the TMT, the tooth movement table, and look for major extrusions, because sometimes my eye doesn't pick those up. And then I'm gonna make sure those have an attachment, and that's pretty much it. So yes, I'm gonna put a lot of attachments on the case, but guess what? My ClinChecks are gonna work. So, and you know what? Yes, ClearCorrect and some of the other ones have slightly fewer attachments because their plastic is stiffer and their trim line is higher, but it's also less healthy for the teeth. More pain, more discomfort, not good for perio patients in my opinion, and I'm sure a lot of periodontists will agree. All perio patients go to Invisalign for me. They do never, ever, ever go to ClearCorrect or any other aligner company, major aligner company that has high trim lines or stiff plastic. So, yeah. All right. Have a great day. Thanks.